Coming up right after the break, some people consider it the pandemic of the 80s. Today is World AIDS Day, and we'll take a look at how a group in New York City is hoping to make it easier for people to live with that condition. Stay with us. This is BNC Prime. Today is World AIDS Day, a day to remember all those lost to the virus, but also a time to celebrate how far society has come when it comes to research and medication.
Yeah, so one group in New York City focuses on helping newly diagnosed people learn to live with the virus. Ashley Lyotis is in New York with more on Alliance for Positive Change.
More than 35 million people have died from HIV or AIDS. World AIDS Day is a reminder that education is still vital.
World AIDS Day is like just to let people know it's still here and we're knocking it out. We are knocking it out and we're celebrating the fact that we've come so far with the medicines. A lot of people are becoming undetectable. People are living with it now.
About 38 million people are living with it worldwide. But despite having scientific advancements since the 80s, there is still a stigma surrounding the virus. Howard Ori and Nyasika Bravo met through HIV/AIDS outreach work. Now, their own experiences help them to be advocates of HIV prevention and education with Alliance for Positive Change.
What brought me there was being HIV positive for the first time. It was hard for me because I was really depressed. And I see people with HIV, because I was in a residential treatment program, but I seen people laughing, they were smiling, playing cards, in relationships, going to work, having fun. And I'm looking at them, how do you do this? I mean, what's so happy joy about having HIV.
Alliance for Positive Change is a nonprofit that helps New Yorkers with HIV/AIDS and other chronic health conditions get medical care, peer support, and housing assistance, all to help them live better lives. Through the peer program, those who have been impacted by these challenges give support to people who are dealing with similar struggles.
So we open our doors to these clients that sometimes they don't have information if they're first being diagnosed. They don't know what it is to take medication. They don't know what it is to take care of themselves. They don't know what it is to have some sobriety in their life. A lot of times they don't have social skills. So you have to, you know, you interact with them and you start to teach them these things.
During the pandemic, much of the outreach is virtual or over the phone, but many have a renewed sense of purpose and hope, like Bravo.
From where I was to where I am today, if it wasn't for these programs and it wasn't for the Alliance and other places like the Alliance, I wouldn't be where I am today.
Reporting in New York City for the Black News Channel, I'm Ashley Lyotis. Yeah.